I'm attempting to get the driver for driver car. I've got the amplifier I built before, but it's been put in basically because I took parts of it. I'm now going to put them back, and I've lost the circuit diagram, so I can't remember what the circuit was. And still, I find it difficult to work out from the actual wiring. So, here is the. This is a choke which I have chosen stops power going into the house, and that's the output here goes to the card, and there's the sensor for the output, and the switch, and this way around the wrong way, you've got to make sure these two things right, otherwise the earth is correct, it's not correct, you need one earth. And be careful. I think that's right. I think it's right. Yes, it is right. But it's a really good way to show it's right. And this is the input. And I'd rather that for a signal generator over there. And that doesn't work. I've not seen any signal get through it. And that's possible. I've broken the transistor. I've put an extra transistor in here, which is a little medium power transistor, which is why there's an emitter follower. I think there's a sort of it. There's a sort of it. There's a sort of this one. I'm not very good at soldering, you see. I used to be, but I can't see where there's actually a short on that. Which is short into case. That needs to be removed. The power's on it, so I've just had to get it very important. And just take off that short. It's out of the leak. Solder doesn't adhere to the case, but it can touch it. And the solder blob got down. It's going to melt it off. This iron is not enough. So that's what we've got. That was a bad contact. And I've still got a positive portion. And this just goes to the emitter around here. That goes to the base of that one or something. And the collector goes here, which is about where the power comes in. And this is the bias resistor I've taken out. And I'll try to short out the other biasing system, which is probably not a good idea. So the input went straight onto the base, which is probably not a good idea. I thought it was a good idea at the time. But the circuit was done, somebody knew what he was doing. And it was actually my friend Brian, who's he's actually been knocked out. I think he's been knocked out of the system because they've either brainwashed him or destroyed his brain. I don't think they're destroying him. Lads have been to destroy his wisdom or something. I think he'll shrink his brain or something. He's stupid. And he was in agreement with it. So it was a good idea. And, they think that people with shrunk brains make more money. But they do shrunk quicker as well. But he's... probably not able to have a PhD, never have a PhD. So. But he might come back and he might recover. When the tranquilizer wears off, he might recover. But he doesn't believe that yet so long, and that's not important enough to. And I don't think he believes in this machine anymore either. It's very primitive when I'm doing this crude. But I'm not very good at soldering. One of my weak points is construction, you know. And you've got to construct something to explain what you were. I used to be better than I am now. But I'm 90, so that's lovely. And you've got a real mess. You've got a huge dirt of a solder over there. That doesn't actually answer that circuit there. So that's the input. That's the input there. And that's right. And that's the biasing of the input. That's the biasing input. So why is that there? I don't know. I can't remember what I said it was now. Anyway, and I put the transistor, I thought it is a resistor actually, that's a point. I put the input transistor, I've got to alter that. No, that's right. The output, the emitter follower goes down. That's right. And this is the input. That input obviously needs a resistor on it. I've forgotten the input of this circuit for emission coil. It shouldn't actually need it, but with a capacitive coupling, it will need a resistor to give something there. So it has to be, otherwise the capacitor will charge up and stop the circuit. That's really what's happening. You get a squeeze when you get charged, the squeeze and so on. And so the input is open, is floating, so it's not a very good idea. And but if I had that, I need a capacitor. A decoupling capacitor, perhaps that's the input. The input is floating. The floating input is probably not a good idea. So I'm not quite sure where to put this capacitor. I had it on the input before, and it was floating, but that's not really a good problem. But you've got a capacitor, a transistor, the actual current flow alters the level, and that's not good. So I think that has to be altered. If it's DC coupled, it's okay, but you've got to make sure the DC isn't too high to blow the transistor. That's being hot and being hot. There's no power in it. And so there's the input not there. That's the input not there. So where the input there. That's the input. So I can't see where it goes. It's important. Have something go somewhere. So the input going there. Just down there. Comes out here. Goes down there. Comes out here. And I can see if there is an input there. That's an idea to see if it's without the power on, see if there's an input there, which is important. So I'll put that, so I can see a circuit around the input. But that's important for that, right? So trace the signal. First of all, trace the signal. And that's quite, it is on, but it seems to be amazing. The earth, that was the earth leaf. That's the important. Because we have only one earth, we've got two earths. That's the earth there. So there is a signal. There's a signal. And it's, well, and you see it's squidging. You can see it. It's squidging. It's going up and down. It's squidging. So and you can see the DC cut off there. Interesting, that's. You've got that. That may be main frequency hum. You see the bottom here, this bottom up here, is where the transistor is conducting, and that's where the pulses come from. So that's all right. But when you've got a capacitor, it self biases and sits a particular level. It's not a good idea. So I've got to bring that level down to here, actually, down to here. So the transistor assisting at a, well, it's positive, so it's a positive level, and which is probably conducting at that point. So it needs some, well, it's actually 500 millivolts, so it's a half a volt, which is about right for the induction. So that's okay. So I've got a bias cell, and I think a transistor, see what the current is, the gain is about 40, and it has a 500 milliamp output. So 40 is about 10 milliamps, isn't it? It's not 10 milliamps. And with this thing going up like volts, it's quite high. So it could be increased, but there's no power in it. So I need to bias it or something. The other way of doing it is to DC couple it. And not to have to put the capacitor somewhere else, which is, not quite sure where to put it, because you've got a bias. So the capacitor could be put, between the main, this transistor here, and so it's in there, so much in here. It's just in that place, so it's going there, instead of the output. Good. And that has the same problem with the second transistor. It's probably not there yet. So at least it's biased. You know, when you have an unbiased circuit, it never works. It never works. Unbiased circuits never work. But they always try unbiased circuits, of course. You used to do bias through the battery in there. But you can bias it by a diode. You know, diodes are not biased. What's that? From the small transistor. So this is circuit. That's the DC. So if I put I'm biasing resistor, I've got it. You see, I'm going to get a biasing resistor. I've got a stub of resistors, so I need to put one in. And that is actually a possible circuit. I put the power on. There it is. Put the power on and see what it does and see what the output does. Let's see. It's actually gone down. That's interesting. There's the pulses. Let's see what happens. Bunching is gone. All sorts of things. See what's in the pulses. So I'm going to see also if the transistor gets hot. Trash is cold. This one here. There's the signal. That's got a stim signal. That's where it's come. Pressing is up anyway. I'm going to get with that. And there's the output. Well, there is something there. Now I'm going to put the power on. Bang. It's gone. Just a little bit. Tell the current by the heater is getting hot. So I need another scope in it. That's so interesting. Let's see where it is. See where the voltage is. Let's see. Channel 1 is it? Channel 2. It's not like having a. That was 100 millivolts. There's our ball there. And there is a slight oscillation there, but that's pretty much as good as it was before. So that sounded good. So, no good at all. But I always have these problems, the circuits. And the DC current, who's DC current? That's why I took out the bias resistor. So it could just be that that's actually one, is it 10 meg, is it? I can't see that show there. 10 watt, 1K. 10 watt 1K. The current is too high. The current is too high. I haven't measured it. But really, I should measure the current through the transistor. Which is actually probably about 10 amps because the transistor is getting on. That's wrong. You know, anyway, the current of the transistor, you've got to break the circuit. Well, I could do it. It's probably on there. Yes, right, and that's up. Put a meter in there. And what the current is. So I could take that coil out and put a meter in instead to get the transistor current. That's what I'm going to do. I've got more and more meters, so I can do that. It's probably about like how it's on the high range. I don't want 10, otherwise it blows up the meter. It's not as close to the fuse on the base, it's got a fuse. The fuse is going to cut out of there. So there's that. And put this on the. Yeah. This is a short circuit, of course. It's good enough there, yeah. That's a short circuit. There's a spreader currently, if I turn it on, it's only, as I said, it's actually 1 amp, 1.39 amps. Well, that's what it should be. It gets hot with 1.39 amps. So I can't find an AC current with that. So I've got a DC current there, and an AC current. That's a draw out the washers. It's actually very low. Well, let's increase the washers. Let's just increase this. There's no IC current, which is not good. Let's just turn this off. Put it on the input, and see what's happening on the input. And I do that, and there's the and I put that on the output, the input to this transistor. And if we put it on the input to this transistor, I think that's what I'm doing. Let's see how put that transistor. Oh, yes. Didn't do much with it. Sort that. It's 9. Spot when I put it on this. It was at least nuts and solder, not good, you know, but great nuts and solder on it. I'm not very good at doing soldering now. I used to do that better, you know. So that's no good. So it's actually that's a reasonable power now. Let's actually increase the signal. It didn't do any good. Increasing the signal doesn't produce a bigger deflection. That's interesting. I'll put it on the input on the other side of the capacitor. That's the responsible for the big latched up. It doesn't that's interesting. It doesn't increase. It's just there's no signal on it. Where is it? So look at the input itself. Did you lose him using a signal somewhere? That's it's not getting in. But actually, this is. It's not a signal from a server generator. There's no signal from a server generator. That means it's Earth. Let's see if a server generator works. It is working. There is it's modulated, then I might should be modulated. Let's see what the frequency is. It's actually 50 hertz. That's the oscillation coming out of the voice. It shouldn't be modulated like that. That's rubbish. That's rubbish. What's the voltage? It's actually 7 volts. 7 volts. That's right. So that should go somewhere. Where's it going? You see, it may be shorted out by something. There's no signal there. That's the signal going into the transistor. There it is. There's a signal there. So when it gets to the transistor, it stops. There it is. The voltage is right. There it is. Now put this on the output of the transistor. It's gone. It's gone. And I've blown the transistor off and screwed it first of all. That's the output. There's no signal on the output. Whatever it is, that is 62 milliwatts, which is actually quite small. I don't understand that. Just actually doing anything like that. Doing something like that. So there's no power. So where does that go? It must be shorting it, So if it's the gain of transistors 40, it has to sit with the bias current. With a bit of follow, isn't normally a bias current. Because there's not one, there's another one on it, it's off. But if it's capacity coupled, there will be one, because it will sit at the switch off light. So it needs to turn it on. So if I want the current in the transistor. So transistor's got to be a 10 by 10 pulses. So it's got to sit at zero. So this biasing is going to come off. This biasing is going to come off, let's see. Right. And then do it differently. If I take the biasing off, which is that's why I get a big cut through the transistor. I take the biasing off, which is turn off the power, it shorts it out, and then go to the battery power, which is the mains. There's no mains on this at all. That's the biasing off. So I've got the transistor unbiased. There is a resistor network there. That resistor network, what does that do? That's right on the biasing. So the biasing, that's actually since we have a biasing, so certainly there's no biasing, so that's not biasing. That's improved things. Let's see what the biasing current is. And actually, it's still not current. It's actually AC current is now 0.6 amps. DC, with AC it's 0.03 amps, and DC it's current of 0.5 amps. So, it is actually doing something now. It still needs biasing. Let's see what the output for the transistor is. There is an output. Let's see what the output of this transistor is. It's dying. That's the output. Now if I turn that on, that's actually got a DC. It's actually turning power. It's actually working. It's 0.03 amps AC current. So there's an issue. And that should now go in series with the series. I've got enough crocodile clips, so that's a joke. I'll find out. This one goes on there. And then from there. I need my breakfast here now. And that's how I do it. Up and out. Wedge it in there, should I wedge it? It's not a good contact. Wedge it. What's the input to the transistor? There's an input. So that means the voltage of the input isn't high enough to switch on the transistor. That's what it means. So what is the voltage? Three volts. But it's negative. So at least the actual. Not very good. The actual positive voltage is quite small. So there's no pulses. I don't understand it yet. There's the input to it. Washes up quite a lot. That's actually quite high. That's one of the highest. That's the same, obviously. It's a damaged transistor or something. It might be a damaged transistor. But it's just the gain. No gain! It was one out when it was faster, so it is working. So it's understandable. I've could have got, I'm not very good at this, I used to do it, but not very good now. But normally when you're doing, that's the signal going into the transistor. So the positive bias is, which is it, it's just there. Is actually 1 volt, so that's half a volt. So that's the voltage you turn it on, and then the rest of the voltage is the current. So you get the rest of the current. After that, the current voltage. So although it turns it on, it doesn't appear there as a voltage. So it should be a current pulse. So there should be a current pulse coming out. I can't see current pulses on this thing because I need a voltage. It needs to be quite a large voltage so far. It's because of these, I presume these resistors have something to do with that. I've got the outlet sensors that go straight to the mesh. And that's the load resistor to the input. And when I had that resistor, it actually biased it. That's the biasing there. I need a different biasing. Turns it off altogether. So when I put the biasing on, it rises to 1 volt. And that turns the transistor on. But it's still enough driving power somewhere. I look at the output. There's this transition that will blind out this way. It'll be yours or something. That's just the way. I used to do this testing thing. I was trying to do it with somebody, but I'm not very good at it. Let's see. That's the earth, and that's the line for that person. I take out this biasing factor, that might be interesting. That's the load on the input. That's actually store. So the phosphorus gushers disappear. Let's just take off this. I'm going to see if it's actually doing it happily. That's another. That's a 40. 40 grams. 40. It's got mass frequency on it. I don't understand that. Mad oscillation. Well, it's modulated. It should be ugly. Proportionally. It's type 1. So that's the watches. It's unlocked. Why is it modulated? Something's altering. It's not a very good person. Good. It's not a very good oscillator, is it? It's not, they don't have modulation like this. It's good oscillator like this. So, that point is 40. I think it's 40. But what frequency is it, let's see? Is it 50 hertz? It is 50 hertz. But universe is difficult to see on this. No different. There's a half frequency. It's probably interesting on these frequencies. It's the similar difference, isn't it? Attenuation isn't doing either. That's interesting. There's no attenuation. It's the same, but you have the, I think there's an RF signal there. This could be oscillating at RF frequency. That's what I thought. Which case I wouldn't have stopped listening to it. The sound is wrong. So what frequency is actually? I don't understand it. This is, it says 50 there. I'm trying to say it's 50 hertz, but there's a high frequency device in the background. It says 50 hertz on there. What's the time base? It's 50 seconds. 120. So that's. So it is 50 hertz. It's 50 hertz. And there's a modulation on there, a much higher frequency. So maybe the mains is going up and down. That's what I'm. And I'm not interested in the mains, Disconnect it from here. Disconnect it from that one. That's right and plugged in. Everything on that. That's gone now. Oh, it's gone back. I've disconnected it from there. This is, don't understand. And the fault finding I have got is serious. I used to do a job when I was good at it. I was better at it when I did a job. That's the input bias. This is the input bias. This is the input bias. That's function. So the input 5 cents for perhaps in the other, that's the solar amount of the input. I did though, that sorted out, but it didn't make any difference. I'll try the input to actually sort out the thing. So. That's now for us. That's another sentence of panel. It's a search in the input there. Actually, there's quite a lot there, so yeah. Who's that? Check for the earth on. That's not. That's more like it. Put that on there. So. It's actually high. It's interesting. I don't know what I'm doing here. I'm not doing very well. I'm not very good at second design. See how I'm not good at that. I just don't understand. star-shaped or a transistor. It could be the transistor's blown up. I don't think it is because it gives a current when you put a bias on it. It's not good, it's not good. Let's take this biasing off the input. Cut the wire. When you take the biasing off, you cut the wire. Let's cut the wire. And then you reconnect it to see if it doesn't do any good. Then you reconnect it with the solder. Okay. So let's increase the level. That's a good sign. So she got something now, so now out. That's good. Now I'll put that on there. Daft desires, it was working. It's not working. It's good to strip the other trashes. There's a pulse there. There should be a pulse here. Yeah. Actually, there's a pulse there, which is positive. Actually, a positive pulse. That's good. And with a collector. This is a better. It's actually showing us. Terminal. It could be a current pulse. It could be a current pulse. If we put, I think we put 100 on resistor in there to see if there's a current pulse. Let's see what the current is. It's because of our resistance, as it's just what to say. It's a little forces, narrow forces. There is a current, that's what I see. There's actually 1 amp AC there, that's what we got. We got some. We've got a current box now. We've got a current box. That's where the mask. And because of that, that thing doesn't make a difference. 1 amp AC. So there is something there. So there should be pulses on there. Modify the circuit to essentially directly. There's no bias in now. No bias. It's not battery resistor. So it's stretching this way through this capacitor. So I get pretty small. And if we assert the capacitor. At that time, and then take the capacitor out, there's only 0.29 points, 2,092 hours of DC as a shortcut. So that needs to go back on the direct coupler. So the capacitor it automatically biases the wrong bias. So it's the auto bias is the problem. You need a DC restorer. Very important. Okay. The DC restore. That always was the problem with biasing the load. Because I can put the load on the other side, put the load on the transistor, which would bias the transistor, which is quite trivial on the transistor. That's very trivial for our transistor. I can't bias it through the transistor, of course. That's a mistake. Bias it on it. So take this, that goes off there. That's all. Goes on the transistor and the capacitor. The capacitor still goes there, so bias it goes on the transistor. So, goes up there. it very carefully. That's washing back on. Now I've got to connect that capacitor that to the washing. This bit will do, no matter what this will do, no matter what it is, I've got the floor, but hang on, I need to clean it a bit, and that goes across there, that goes to the solenoid, and to get the, I'll still do 100 hours on that thing. Do you have breakfast? I can't remember, I haven't got any food actually, it's a problem. My vegetable soup from here. I bought food, electronics of food, and that is a sort of food. This is the It's reconnected. It's actually got a picture there now. Not sure on that either. Just to show that one. This capacitor is actually coming in. The other side of the capacitor doesn't exist. It will be there because of the connection divider. But it is just there. Yep, look at that. It's not high enough. It's not high enough. Not high enough signal for this. I'll have to turn it on. You've got the same transistor, which is Now it's hidden. Let's see the current is. So the current is in the DC now. The DC current. Got larger. This is 140, I hand out 1.4 milliamps of amps of the DC current, and the rest of it is the AC current. What do you see? There's some breakfast in there. I've got to start tummy upset in there. It's probably infecting me. and that, and that's the output. Well, that, the power on, that's on. So the power put in the button is actually turned the transistor on. And because the voltage wasn't high enough to operate at the gate, it didn't turn on. I need to watch a bit. That transistor is probably right. I need to increase the input voltage. Input is 7 volts there, but it attenuates it. That's too much attenuation. Right? Too much attenuation. So this is an oscillator, not a synopsis.